Hey everybody! So many people told me to make that my new intro, so I did it again. We'll see what happens. This video is gonna be in like bits and pieces because some of it is from the video I did with my mom the other day about John Edwards, and then some of it I filmed earlier today, and some of it obviously I'm filming right now. So it's not gonna be that confusing, just follow along. I'm trying to get back to like my old background and like my old Andrew TMI roots. So I'm working on the background, okay? Don't judge it, don't look at it yet. I'm kind of scared to talk about what I'm gonna talk about in this video because I always find it annoying when people lie about this stuff just to like get views and stuff, which is not what I'm doing. This is something that really happened to me the other day. If you don't want to believe it and you think I'm lying, then enjoy it for just like a spooky story. It really happened. I was really freaked out. I woke Brittany and my brother up at 4 a.m. to come sit with me upstairs.
It's true. I have the receipt.
She does have the receipts. But yeah, I'm kind of just gonna be explaining what happened, what I saw the other day, and other weird things that have happened since, and why I think it might be my grandpa's ghost. I have a very special Hunt a Killer announcement. That made a mess. Look how many freaking boxes they sent me. If you are late to the game, Hunt a Killer is a monthly subscription murder mystery box that sends a murder mystery right to your front door. It lets you like put yourself into your own murder mystery instead of just like sitting on the couch and watching a show for hours on end. You can literally be in your own live action murder mystery. Each one of these subscription boxes is considered an episode, and every episode includes case files, audio files, clues, evidence, documents, all helping you eliminate suspects until finally you get down to who committed the murder. You can play by yourself, with friends, with an online community, or with me because I have them now. And let me start by saying, not even part of this sponsorship, I already played a little with my friends. I'm gonna insert some of that footage here. Nobody in that video even knew I was recording. Like, we did not do that for the sponsorship. We were genuinely playing and having such a good time. We are all blown away by the detail that is put into this game, and I really think you guys are gonna absolutely love it. I would love to live stream this game and play with you guys. So go buy your own Hunt a Killer today. Use my discount code, which is gonna be Andrew TMI in the description down below for 20% off your first box. Go get Hunt a Killer. I'm telling you guys, not part of the sponsorship. I am in love with it. It is an amazing company, an amazing game, and you're gonna love it. Thank you so much to Hunt a Killer for sponsoring this video. I love you guys. And let's get right into the video. I'm not exactly like 100% sure what I talked about in the other clips with my mom, but I'm gonna insert them here. Before we get into those though, I just wanna say that this was a crazy experience for me. It's not something that happens all the time. You guys do know that I saw my grandpa once when I was younger. I've talked about that in one of my videos. When I saw him last time, he was kind of walking up the stairs. He was in complete form, just a little bit see-through. I know how cliche that sounds. It's a story that's been in my family for over 20 years now. It happened, it's never changed. Basically, I was up at 3:40 in the morning editing a video, which you guys know anytime from 3 a.m. to 4 a.m. is like the witching hour. It's like the very haunted hour when like all the spirits and everything come out. I don't know much about it. I just know every time I get up to go pee at 3 a.m, I'm terrified. So I was sitting there editing my video, and I'm obviously sitting there staring at my laptop screen, sitting on the couch, and just beyond my laptop screen, I saw like a white mist slash blur kind of move out of the living room slash kitchen from where I was sitting in into like the hallway. And now I know last time, like I said, I saw my grandpa in full form, but this time it was just like a blur slash mist. I believe I never saw any other spirits or my grandpa again because I've been so terrified and closed-minded to it. At least that's what Haley tells me anyway. This wasn't anything just like my eyelashes or like just my eyes seeing stuff because I was tired. Like, it was 100% there, and that's why I'm really making a video about this, because it was so bizarre and so realistic and there that I was like, you know what, I'll just talk about it in a video. If you guys don't believe me, it's fine, but this is what happened. Immediately I froze and I was just sitting there like, what the fuck just happened? And within like 5 to 10 seconds, cold hit me. And I don't say like cold air or cold wind, because it wasn't wind. Like, my hair didn't move. I didn't feel wind. I just felt cold, almost like a cold front hitting me or just coming around me. Obviously, I know, everyone knows that when you see a spirit, like they say it's very cold or whatever. That's when I was like, okay, this is realistic. This is real. I immediately picked up my phone, texted and called my brother and Brittany, who were sleeping downstairs. I never do this. Like, they both had work the next morning, but I was like, please come upstairs. Like, I literally just saw a ghost. Put my paranormal paranormal videos aside, because no one in my personal life is like a huge fan of my paranormal videos. Like, I don't consider myself a paranormal YouTuber, so I'm not doing this just for content. I don't want to be labeled a paranormal YouTuber. I just make videos about my life. So I texted and called Joe and Brittany. They came upstairs and they were sitting with me, and nothing else happened the rest of that night, but I was really like shook. I was terrified. Finally, they went back downstairs and I was just like very on guard. But I did realize a few minutes after that this is the day my mom took out the John Edwards tape with my grandpa on it and put it on the dining room table, because I was recording that video the very next day. So it's just weird that my mom went digging in the basement for this boombox and the tape that my grandpa contacted us on, and that was sitting on the table. And then I saw this ghost that I believe to be my grandpa passing through. So anyway, fast forward to the next day, I was telling my mom about it. Joe and Brittany were there again. I was like, "Mom, like, I saw a ghost. You have no idea." She immediately cut me off and she was like, "Wait, do not tell me where it was. I'm gonna tell you exactly where it was." She went right over to the exact spot and she was like, "This is where you saw it." And guys, it was like the exact spot in my house. Apparently, she knew that because Lucy and Roxy, when Roxy was alive, always went over to the spot and would just stare up and nonstop bark at this one spot, almost as if a person was standing there and they were barking at the person's face. So that's weird to me. Now, fast forward to a few days later, it was me, my brother, Brittany, and our friends Dylan and Nikki. We were all sitting around the dining room table. Actually, it was the night we were playing Hunt a Killer. Someone kept knocking on our front door, and when we would go to the door, no one would be there. I have like a pretty big front lawn, so like it's not like they'd be able to just like run to the street. We would see them. There were no cars on my block, like nothing. I'd actually love for my brother to tell this, because my brother like doesn't give a shit about YouTube. He doesn't care about the paranormal stuff, like he doesn't care. But even he was going outside and searching for whoever was knocking on my door. I know you guys know that one of my most popular videos is a ghost knocked on my door and I have the surveillance footage. So now I'm wondering, like, was it my grandpa all along knocking on the door? It does not look like him in the surveillance footage. I'll give it that. Like, it doesn't look like him. Or it could be a coincidence and it could have been a random guy knocking on my door. But the only weird thing is this time the person was knocking, and when we would run to the front door, nobody would be there. And it happened multiple times throughout the night. And I was like, you know what? I know I'm not crazy, because it's my brother who's like very invested in finding out who's knocking at the door. And that's how I knew I wasn't crazy, because he doesn't buy into any of this shit. That's kind of the gist of it. This isn't like a huge, like, crazy written out video. I just wanted to get on here and share it with you guys. I know you guys are interested in this stuff. You guys are even more interested in it than I am. So for those of you that enjoy it, here you go. Happy fall season. If you guys do want more videos like this, I could start keeping tabs on my phone of all the little tiny creepy things that happen and just make huge compilation videos. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. And do not forget to go get Hunt a Killer so we can play together. Use my discount code AndrewTMI for 20% off your first box. It's going to be in the description down below, as well as all of my social medias, which you guys know I am popping on social media. So go follow me. Until next week, I will see you guys next week. Bye.